Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to be looking at feedback modulation. This process is very similar to a delay line. Well, it includes a delay line with some feedback, but the creative use of that is inspired by this practice called no input mixing, where you have a mixing desk and you patch it back in on itself and then let feedback happen and control that with the dials. I encourage you to have a look at this particular video and tutorial on no input mixing by Sarah Bell Reed, which is particularly good, and you'll get an idea of what it's about. But we're just going to do something inspired by that in PD. So to do this, we need a feedback delay loop. So let's build our delay line. We're going to have a delay write object, which will write audio data into a buffer. And I'm just going to name our buffer, very simply, buffer. And we can give that buffer a maximum a size. Maximum delay time. So it's going to be 1,000 milliseconds, so it'll be up to 1 second delays possible with this delay buffer. We send a signal to the delay buffer. In the no input mixing situation, what causes the feedback is that there's all inherently a little bit of noise in the mixing signal, in the audio signal, which is then fed back on itself. So we're going to do something similar as a starting point. We're going to start with some noise, and we'll give ourselves a volume control to adjust that noise so that we can manage its level. So I'll go between 0 and 1. This will be the gain stage for that input level. So noise, gain, and that's fed into our buffer. We need to be able to get a delay read object, which will read back from our buffer. So we have to tell it the name of our buffer. And this can have a default delay time, and I'll just give it a very short one of 10 milliseconds. Again, if you think about the no input mixing desk, then it's going to be a very short time between plugging the output of the signal going from the output to the input through a cable. So this kind of emulates that. The output buffer can also have a volume control. So we need to control the volumes of almost everything that's going on in this patch. And it's the adjustment of all of these controls which will give us our creative possibilities. So that also go between 0 and 1. Zero and two. So this is our feedback level. The reason that I'm going higher than one is, of course, it's at the point around one where things get interesting, where the feedback is going on. When it's just below one, then the feedback will start to diminish. When it's just above one, it will start to increase. And so we want to be able to see that as we go. So because it's important to know what that value is, I will put that number box there so we can see what's going on. So this is controlling the amount of feedback, and that feedback is going to go back into the write. So in this sense, we've got this signal going in, then we're reading it back, and we're writing it back at a certain amount of feedback. In addition, of course, to all of that, we need a master output level. And so we can have that fader going from 0 to 1, and that's our volume. And so connect that up. So our feedback, our delayed signal is going to go to our main output, and we'll also put some of the original signal into that main output as well. And then that all goes to our audio outputs to the digital to analog converter, left and right. Okay, I think we are in business. The only thing we probably should also add is just a value to adjust the delay time. This gives us different effects as we change our delay time. So again, we want a very short minimum. You don't quite want it to be zero because we'll just get a computing lockup from a feedback loop. We'll go up to 1,000, which is our maximum. Because I know that the shorter values are more interesting than the higher ones for this, I'm going to change this so it's a logarithmic scale. And this is our delay time. Okay, cool. So there we go. And you can see with this logarithmic scale, we get these small changes in the lower half, and then they increase more dramatically as we go up. So we've got a nonlinear curve controlling that. Okay, enough. Let's see if we get some sound. So we have a delay time. We turn our volume up, increase the gain on the noise. All right, so we hear a little bit of noise. So you can imagine this is your mixing desk, and there's always a little bit of residual noise in that mixing desk. And then what we do is we increase the feedback level. And as we do that, you can possibly hear there's some pitch arising. And you can see that our feedback level is now approaching 1. And as we approach it, we get more and more feedback. As we exceed 1, then the feedback exceeds, and you can see this thing's just blowing up basically on us, and then we can pull it back. So now we can control it in this fashion. When we're close to 1, we get something sort of close to stable. Then we can do things like change the amount of input. That causes us some change, but the most dramatic effect will come from changing our delay time. Alright, so there we have it. This is the very beginnings of our sort of feedback mixer with just some noise, and we're already getting some interesting kind of results that we can perform with. What we can do as well, of course, is we can substitute our noise and actually not make it a no input one, but make it an input modulating feedback, and we can just input a sine wave instead from an oscillator. And of course we can control its pitch. So if we let's move that up to something we can hear, and then turn the volume up, turn our gain up, so we're getting some signal. So there's our original signal as we increase our feedback. That then starts to clip and cause us all the sorts of interesting feedback. And again, the delay time. Create all sorts of other interesting noises. And we can introduce more or less if we get it close to feeding back. And then of course we can change its pitch, bring it down again. Okay. Now, the control of this is a little bit tricky for me because I've just got my mouse which only means I can control one thing at a time. If I connected my MIDI controller up, that would be the ideal thing to do. And then I could control all of these parameters simultaneously. But one final hint about the sorts of things that we can do is if we use the analog to digital converter and take my microphone in as an input, then we can, this again, if we just turn this delay time up, we'll turn the feedback down, we'll hear the delay effect. Probably need to increase the gain, and we need to increase it actually even more than from 1 to 3. There we go. So now we're hearing that. We need to increase our feedback. There's our delay. So then again, you can bring this into feedbacking oscillation. And then, of course, the sound that I make will then be an important part of the feedback. Hello. Talking 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so there you have it. Some modulation feedback fun for the whole family. So give that a go, and I will see you in another video.